Let's talk about dry fire safety. Dry firing is one of the best ways, and certainly one of the cheapest ways, to get some good practice in. But first rule of dry fire is to have a dry gun. And believe it or not, people mess this up all the time. So step one, unload the gun. We're gonna make sure it's unloaded. We're gonna feel, we're gonna look, we're gonna make sure it is totally unloaded. Then we're gonna get the ammo away from the gun. Personally, I like to have it in a different room, so there is no ammo in the room where I'm practicing. And at that point, you kind of make sure the gun is dry. Now, all four rules still apply. We're not gonna point this at anything we don't wanna destroy, and we're gonna point it in a safe direction. So if by chance that you really screwed it up and you shot, it's not gonna go through a wall and hit somebody else. You wanna make sure you're pointing in a safe direction. So as you're doing your dry fire, you wrap that up. And then what I like to do is, and especially people a lot of times will dry fire with their carry gun. When your dry fire session ends, you need to say to yourself, and maybe even say it out loud, dry fire practice is over. And when you reload the gun, if you're gonna reload the gun because it's your carry gun, you're gonna put it in your safe or whatever, you go, this gun is now loaded. No more practice. The way people screw this up a lot is they go, maybe just one more dry fire. And then the gun's loaded and they shoot their TV or something worse. So be sure to be safe when you dry fire. Make sure it's with a very unloaded gun. Just a few tips for you.